want to know the reason why I seem to shun the nighttime sky. I know you think it odd and strange that such as I, who long for change and dreams of starships, outward flights, should never watch the stars by night. One evening not so long ago, out on a road that few folks know, with only trees on either side, the engine of my old car died. And as I wondered what to do, one of my wildest dreams came true. One moment there was nothing there, the next just hanging in midair, a ship, a thing of sound and light. Then I stepped out into the night, and as I stopped in awe to stare, I was engulfed in a blinding glare. And others have been far from kind, when they seemed petty, cruel, and blind, when being different made you ache, when lonely tears could fill a lake. Have you not dreamed one night or day a ship would carry you away? So when I felt them touch my mind, I tried to leave my fears behind. I tried to make them see that I belong with them beyond our sky. And held within that beam of light, I prayed, yes, prayed my dream was right. They weighed me, sifted every thought, each feeling, all that I'd been taught. Everything I thought I knew, and all I thought was false or true. My hopes and doubts, my shame and pride, laid out before them side by side. I felt not heard their weary sigh, and then they left the star-strewn sky. Suddenly as they had come, they left me empty, cold and numb. My soul turned into ash and sand, still holding out one yearning hand. I ruin myself with sound and light, and read or watch banal TV, or drink till I can't think or see, or lose my dreams in drug-filled sleep. But when I see the stars,